Let me make sure I'm online. Okay. Hello, I'm Alex from AP Ink. So today I'm going to be picking up where I left off last time. This month, I thought it would be fun to go through kind of classic horror or scary movies and doing kind of like the main characters, whether that be monsters or humans. So right now I'm working through some of the monsters from Hellraiser. So today I'm going to be working on Chatterer. So I've got a piece of sketchbook paper, a 4B pencil, some more supplies off to the side. I'm just going to get into this. Just like the other characters that I've drawn from this movie franchise, this is like a figurine and not a still from the movies.
Thank you.
Hello. This is Chatterer from Hellraiser. I know these are looking kind of rough to start, but I'm hoping they at least kind of resemble the character at the end. I've been doing more creature designs and like abstracts recently. I guess I've kind of gotten out of practice drawing people. I No, I don't have any plans for Halloween. Falls on a Thursday this week or this year. Hopefully going to bed on time so I can get up for work the next day. It probably sounds kind of boring trying to go to bed on time, but it never happens. You had one night where you went, ate dinner and went right to bed after. Do you normally go to bed around that time? Are you more of a night owl or a morning person? Yeah, I'm a night owl trying to make myself be a morning person. Oh no. Alcohol-laced chocolate. I don't know how strong those are. Is it enough to kind of put you off the next day? It just made you sleepy. Okay. I don't know if that really looks like a mouth. A beautiful smile. I don't know if you'd say that if you actually met this guy. There's a reason why he's called the Chatterer. He's got this thing about biting. Have you seen Hellraiser, Asakura? Yeah, there are a lot. could add some of these details, but I think it would end up looking busy and maybe not make a whole lot of sense. Okay, I think I'm gonna move on to the liner. So aside from that red, excuse me, I've got a black brush pen that I'm going to use for the line art. Are you just hanging out, Asakura, or are you drawing too? Surfing the web. Oh, you got a Comic-Con there? Who's on the guest list this year? Okay, so from here, to follow the line I drew for the chain, it was really just for reference, because what I'm gonna do is following that line, I'm just gonna make small kind of O's. What? The silver and blue Power Rangers and from Power Rangers in Space are gonna be there. That's awesome. And the Red Ranger. Okay, so wait. Did you guys actually have Power Rangers, the American version there? Because I know at least the fighting sequences were taken from, I don't know, an Asian show, probably also called Power Rangers. That's kind of funny. Okay, I'm gonna give that a minute to dry. I don't know if that chain really makes any sense. The color scheme on this is really simple, just like with all of these creatures. To try and kind of recreate this kind of twisted, mangled skin on his face, just using colored tones. Thank you. pastel pink for the base color. And then just to see if this works together, light peach. I don't think so. Cinnamon toast. I don't think that's going to work either. If I use cinnamon toast as the base color, and then maybe terracotta. That's gonna be a bit too dark. But to go over with the cinnamon toast again to try to blend it out might not make too much of a difference. And Pinhead, I use pale peach and sienna brown. But they have different complexions. See, Pinhead is more white-skinned, so is Cutthroat. Kind of white tone, maybe a bit on the gray side for Cutthroat. But Chatterer looks like he's a bit more flesh tone. Maybe if I'm a bit more light with the terracotta and then still go over it again with the light peach, or no, cinnamon toast. See, I don't think light peach. Let me get a clean piece. Okay, it's not super clean because I've obviously used it, but there's a little bit more room. Light peach. Terracotta is going to look even darker on this. But cinnamon toast on the light peach. I tend to use the light peach and cinnamon together. I think this will end up being a bit too close. Versus using cinnamon toast along with terracotta. And then use I suppose instead of trying to recreate this kind of mangled swirl pattern, that I could just use the skin color straight and just shade it. It wouldn't end up looking quite as grotesque as he actually is, though. I don't know. While I try to decide what to do, I'm going to move on and erase the pencil and at least get into inking his outfit. Going to use a kneaded eraser. Thank you. Okay, so I'm going to use slate gray for the base color of his outfit, and then dark matter gray to shade it. dark matter gray to shade his clothes. Oh, wait. The gloves that he's wearing covers like half his thumb, his pointer finger, and like his ring finger on both hands. So to fill that in here, yeah, fashionable. not sure what I should do with the skin. I'm gonna add a bit of white gel pen to add shine here and there. I mean, here his clothes are a bit more matte. I'm just going off of like this outfit here, especially here where he's wearing like a shiny leather, and she might be wearing a shiny leather, which makes me think that Chatterer might also have a shiny leather. If I could have found a clean clean still from the movie. So I think for his teeth, I'm going to use GG3 Green Gray. Okay, I guess we're gonna just jump into this. So I'm gonna use light peach for the base color, and then terracotta to try to add some light details. I might pull that cinnamon toast in to shade this. Okay, I don't know if that really works for Chatterer. I am going to leave this one here, though. I've got one more creature. This big guy. I'll work on him tomorrow. Thanks, Asakura, for hanging out. Thank you to anybody else who watched or watches. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks. Bye.